Hey guys, John from FlightMikeAlpha.com, and today we're going to be talking about how to use our E6B to find wind correction angles and ground speed based upon our winds aloft and what sort of heading we found that we're going to be flying off of our sectional chart. So how fast we're going to go, how long it's going to take us to get there, our fuel burn, all those sorts of things get derived from this. Make sure you have your E6B handy and you can follow along with us. Go ahead and rewind or drag on back to replay anything you need to see twice. Work through it a couple times so it becomes cemented in your memory and you'll be good to go for your test. So we have our E6B here, and what we want to do with that is initially slide our little grommet down to 100. So we're going to be right at 100 start there, and we could start at any number, but we want to just start at a nice easy round number, 100, and then we can proceed up for our wind. So we're going to use 250 at 1.8 for our winds aloft. So we're going to dial this to 250 and then put a little dot at 18 up from our starting point, 18 up from our grommet. So I'm going to use a little piece of scotch tape there with a little dot on there. You could use a sticky note or a dry erase marker, anything you really want. So I could also go down to 90 and then just put my little dot at, you know, 18 up from there, but it's just easier to start at 100 and then put my dot at 118. So my winds 250 at 18 knots are my winds aloft. Now my true heading on this that I measured from my sectional chart, my true heading for this trip today is going to be 080. So I'm going to dial this around to 080. And then I want to slide my dot up to my ground or my true airspeed. My true airspeed I know is going to be about 110 knots. So slide that little dot to the 110 knot line. Right there, and then I'll read my ground speed through that grommet. It looks like my ground speed is going to be about 128, 129 knots, and that little dot slightly to the right, so it looks like I'm going to have to add about 2 degrees. About 2 degrees, we can see there's 5, there's 10, so about adding 2 degrees to 080, so I should fly a heading of 082, and then plus whatever my magnetic variation is for that area, might be plus an additional 5 degrees, so now I need a magnetic heading of 087 to actually have a ground track of 080 true, and also my ground speed will be slightly higher than my true airspeed. We can now go ahead and calculate our estimated time and route for the trip, our fuel burn for our trip, and we know exactly what heading we're going to need to fly, so we have all our pertinent information. What we did, to do it once more, we started at 100, nice round number. Our winds were 250 at 1.8, so we dialed up 250, went to 1.8 there, and then we went ahead and dialed in what our true course was going to be that we drew on our sectional, which was 080. We slid this on up to our true airspeed, which was 110, based on our cruise performance charts and everything like that, true airspeed of 110, and we found we'd have to turn 2 degrees to the right to actually have a proper ground track, about adding 2 degrees to 080, and then we read our ground speed through that grommet to be about 129. All right, so now let's go ahead and work through one more example problem here. Again, we're always gonna start with our grommet slid down to the 100 mark. So we're down at 100 to start, and then we're gonna say that our winds aloft are 320 at 29 knots. So twist this around to 320, and then go up 29 away from your grommet, and put a little dot. So we're gonna put our dot there at 129. Again, we could have started off at 80 and then put a dot at 109, but it's just easier to start off at 100 and then put your dot 29 up from that. So now we're going to twist around to our true course. We find a true course from the sectional chart, from those true lines, and we found our true course to be 030 for our flight today. So 030 is our true course, and our true airspeed that we calculated from our cruise performance charts was 118. So we're gonna move our little dot on up there to 118. And we're gonna read that our ground speed will be about 105 knots. So now we can use our ground speed with our distance to find our estimated time and route and our fuel burn. We could
go over here and say that looks like, oh, we're gonna have to turn minus 10, minus 12, minus 14 degrees off of our 030. Heading, so we're going to be on a 016 heading, but we're around the Venice airport area, Venice, Florida, so we're going to add 5 for magnetic variation, which would then give us about a 021 heading. So 021 magnetic, 016 true heading to track a 030 true course over the ground. And again, using the 105 knots ground speed based on, we'll just say it's a 50 mile trip to calculate what our estimated time and route is going to be and our fuel burn at say 8 gallons per hour. And of course the fuel burn comes from our cruise performance charts. So that's how you're going to use your E6B to calculate your ground speed and wind correction angle, given that you have your winds aloft and your true course to begin with. Remember, you can always mix and match. If you have your final answer, you could always calculate what the winds aloft are. You could calculate really anything as long as you have the necessary givens.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you have any questions at all, just leave them in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Make sure you give us a thumbs up on our video and you can subscribe to us to follow all our latest episodes over here on the right. Also, go ahead and check out some of these videos down below. And remember, if you can't fly every day, then fly at mikealpha.com. We'll see y'all next time.